Hi students, in the last class I have discussed some properties of colloidal solutions. What are they? Colligative properties, Tyndall effect, color of colloids, Brownian moment, charge on colloidal particles. These properties in the last class I have discussed. Now, in this class I am going to discuss about electrophoresis. Electrophoresis. No, already in the last property, that means the charge on colloids, I have discussed that colloidal particles on their surface contain some charges, either positive charges or negative charges. Based on that, colloids are classified into positive colloids and negative colloids. If a fixed layer on colloidal particle contains positive charge, that is positive colloid. If a fixed layer on the colloidal particle contains negative charge, that is negative colloid. So here we are theoretically saying that charges are there on colloidal particles. What is the proof for that? So for the existence of charges on the colloidal particles, the proof is electrophoresis. What is that? Electrophoresis. What happens in this? In electrophoresis, in a colloidal solution, two platinum electrodes are placed and some external EMF is applied. When external EMF is applied between two platinum electrodes placed in a colloidal solution, their movement of colloidal particles towards any one of the electrodes takes place. This type of movement of colloidal particles towards the electrode of opposite charge is called electrophoresis. So what is electrophoresis? It is the movement of colloidal particles. Movement of colloidal particles towards the electrode of opposite charge, towards the electrode of opposite charge, when an external EMF, electromotive force is applied. So this is the definition for electrophoresis. It is the movement of colloidal particles towards the electrode of opposite charge when an external EMF is applied. So for that, see once this picture. This is a U-shaped tube in which a colloidal solution is taken. This is a cork. Inside there are platinum electrodes. So these are platinum electrodes. Here also there is some cork. It is also platinum electrode. These two platinum electrodes are placed in a colloidal solution. So this is colloidal solution. So in this, some colloidal particles will be there now. Those colloidal particles here move towards only one electrode. These are connected to some external EMF, that means a battery. Suppose it is some positive charge, it is some negative charge. So it is connected to negative terminal of the battery, whereas the other one is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Then this electrode gets a positive charge, this electrode gets a negative charge. Now what is the movement of colloidal particles? So there is a reservoir also here. It is a reservoir. It is for colloidal solution, reservoir for colloidal solution it is. Into this colloidal solution is taken. So when using this reservoir, colloidal solution is filled into this U-shaped tube. External EMF is applied. Then what happens? Colloidal particles all move towards any one of the electrodes. If inside there is positive colloid, all the colloidal particles then move towards cathode. Cathode means having negative charge. The electrode with negative charge is cathode. So this is cathode. This is anode. So the electrode with positive charge is called cathode because it is electrolysis process. In electrolysis process, cathode is assigned a negative charge, anode is assigned positive charge. So here, if the inside colloid is some negative colloid, if it is a negative colloid, what happens? In negative colloid, colloidal particles are having negative charge. That's why they move towards positive electrode. That means all the colloidal particles move in this direction. So in this direction they move. So in that way, these colloidal particles are discharged at this electrode. Okay, so this is the electrophoresis experiment. Have you got what is electrophoresis experiment? Under the influence of some external EMF, colloidal particles move towards the opposite electrode. So this is evidence for the charge on colloidal particles. Theoretically, I had explained in the charge on colloidal. There is a property before this electrophoresis. I had explained earlier. Fifth property, charge on colloidal particles. In that, I said that colloidal particles are present on, colloidal particles are having some charges in the fixed layer. So, this property is evidence for that. What is that? Electrophoresis. Now, this electrophoresis, if in this electrophoresis there is another word, that is electroosmosis. What is that? Electroosmosis means if the movement of electroosmosis is the movement of electroosmosis is the movement of solvent in the reverse direction. In the reverse direction, when the colloidal particles are when the colloidal particles are arrested by some means, so what is electroosmosis? It is the movement of solvent in the reverse direction. Always solvent moves in the opposite direction to that of the movement of colloidal particles. Solvent moves in the opposite direction to that of colloidal particles. So if by any means movement of colloidal particles is arrested, then solvent moves in the reverse direction. So this type of movement of solvent in the reverse direction, when the colloidal particles movement is arrested by some means, is said to be electroosmosis. Okay, so electrophoresis and electroosmosis.